throw four modulation effect modules together, add a central mix control to it, and you could end up with something like the Arbitron by JMJ Sound. In this video, I will show you how it all works and how it sounds. Hi, I'm Marlon, and welcome to the White Noise Studio. The Arbitron is basically four modulators with a central mixing pad. Each modulator can use one of the same 12 modulation effects, which are Cosmic Chorus, Vintage Chorus, Super Chorus, Tape Flanger, Future Flanger, Fat Phaser, Infinite Combs, Liquid Filter, Kinetic Resonator, Chaos Vortex, Rotary Speaker and Space Time. All of these effects have their own set of effect-specific control, but they all share depth, rate and width. Let's check a few like Infinite Combs. It does a shepherd-like tone, which is an infinite rise and decline of pitch. And let's check Space Time. Space Time is a multi-band and multi-tap array of multi-delay lines. To get in depth with all 12 effects would be a little bit tedious. So make sure you check out the plugin yourself, the link is in the description below. The plugin can solo one modulator if you just want to use one effect, or use all four at once. This opens up a whole rabbit hole of modulation options. To blend all these four, you need to use the central mix modulator. This will blend between the four, so you need to find a sweet spot for the best sounding balance between the four. But you can also set a mix modulator to automatically blend the four modulators. You can use sync, which will synchronize to the tempo of the project, where it will rotate through the four effects. By changing range, you can change the range from going from one effect to the other, to a more overall blend and morphing between the four. The speed is set to bars. It can go from 1 bar to a very slow 16 bars. The other two options are free, where you set a speed not synced to the tempo of the project, and random, which will randomly blend the four modulators. You can set the speed though. There's a dry-wet control and input and output volume. These can be linked to get an even distribution. The feed knob down here controls how much the signal from the previous effects feeds into the input of the next effects. The size dial controls the delay sizes for the feedback loops. These two have a major effect on the sound. By default, this plugin is great for slower audio sources, like for instance synth pads, because then you can hear the modulation effects really happening. But don't hesitate to use this plugin on other sources as well. There's a huge amount of presets you can go through. And if you feel you're up for some surprises, the plugin offers 3 steps of randomization with these 3 dices. The first level only changes the modulation controls of each of the 4 modulators. The second changes the modulation controls and the modulation types. And the 3rd dice randomizes everything. There are oversampling options to increase sound quality or save CPU usage. With 4 times oversampling, the plugin takes about 8% CPU usage on my Cubase performance meter with my Ryzen 9 3900 CPU at 48 samples of latency. So it takes some CPU cycles, but given its 4 modulation effects running at once, it's not bad. I would love to have the option to solo more than one modulator for even more flexibility, maybe in a future update. The Orbitron offers an interesting variation on the many modulation effects out there. For me personally, the major interesting points are the 4 different modulators you can use and the automation of those. Check out the plugin, the link is in the description below. Another interesting multi-modulation effect is reviewed in the video displayed on screen. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to learn more about new plugins, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!